After muscle problems, the next big cause of difficulty for albinos is the cornea. The cornea is the smooth, transparent dome that bulges out from the sclera. At least it's supposed to be smooth. My cornea has irregularities. You might have this problem too. This disorder is called astigmatism. The cornea is exposed to the real world. It is what you touch when you inadvertently stick your finger in your eye. It is covered in the front by the eyelid and is kept clean by tears. Think of it as a protective filter for your camera. In addition to protecting the inner eye, the cornea has the major responsibility of focusing light onto your retina. Only a third of the work is done by the lens of the eye. Most of the work has already been done by the cornea. When your cornea has dips and flaws, light doesn't bend enough, or it gets bent too much and bounces around the inside of the eye. The result is vision that is blurred or distorted. Our brain tries to compensate for astigmatism, but it's like trying to Photoshop a blurry photo. There's only so much that can be done. And compensation has side effects, too. With uncorrected vision, people with astigmatism often suffer from eye strain and headaches. One curious thing about the cornea is it has no blood vessels. Sometimes I forget that everything in the body is alive. Fingernails don't feel like they're alive, and neither do bones. But when I think of it, I realize that blood vessels carry nutrition to them, so they must be alive. But the cornea doesn't have any blood vessels. It couldn't be transparent with blood vessels running through it. But in order to be alive, it has to get nourishment somewhere. It turns out that the tears that keep the outside of the cornea clear also deliver some nutrition. But its primary source of nutrition is the gooey liquid between the cornea and the lens. This area, called the aqueous humor, brings oxygen and nourishment to both the back of the cornea and the front of the lens. It removes waste materials and has an antioxidant that helps protect the eye from UV rays. The aqueous humor provides pressure that keeps the eye inflated. The fluid in it is constantly flowing. It comes in one end, through the ciliary body, and is drained into Schlemm's canal. As long as the input and output is balanced, the pressure remains constant. But if the output gets blocked, pressure builds up. Too much pressure can destroy cells, cause gradual decline in visual field, and lead to blindness. This disorder is called glaucoma. Just in front of the lens is a mesh-like structure called the iris. It serves two functions. First, it opens and closes to control the amount of light hit in the lens. It's sort of like the curtains that open and close to reveal the stage at a theater. The iris opens to reveal more of the lens and to let more light reach it. It begins to close when more light than is needed enters the eye. The iris allows a 16-to-1 ratio of change in light intensity, but not for albinos. Let me explain by introducing the other purpose of the iris, to protect the retina. The outer layer of the iris has pigment. When you say you have brown eyes, you're referring to the color of the iris. If there is no pigment here, which is the case with my eyes, this layer is translucent. So I can't block out as much light as you can, even when the iris is closed as far as it will go. Bright light for me is much brighter than it is for you. The condition is called photophobia. It's not fear of light, just sensitivity to it. When working in bright light conditions, my eyes hurt. Maybe it's from squinting to block out the light, but I don't like it. So if I'm in a classroom or office with fluorescent lights, I wear a baseball cap to shield my eyes. I think of it as a portable roof. And when outside, of course, I add wraparound sunglasses. Not very stylish, but effective. Another disadvantage of the translucent iris is that unwanted light passes through it and bounces around inside the eye. Such undirected rays make it hard to get a sharp image on the retina. Sometimes albinos look like their eyes are pink. As light goes through the translucent iris, it hits the blood vessel supporting the iris and two blood vessel systems nourishing the photoreceptors on the retina. If light hits these structures at the right angle, the iris will appear pink. It's just what happens when your camera gives everyone red eye.